The blood in your head thrums and pounds. That pounding blood obscures who you are. An overwhelming loss of memory. How you ended up amidst these hellish flames is just as hidden. You have nothing in your skull, besides your name and a headache. But you are in danger. The dark urge. Whatever that is you. You will claw back the truth. But first, you have to claw your way out of here.
My head.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. Casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
Dead. Good. Someone else got out.
Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind. Schematic of a nautiloid flashes into your mind. Nerves, sinews, as much living being as ship.
Mm-hmm.
1,000 years of humanoid history, elves, dwarves, humans, and more flash behind your eyes.
Release us. To save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please.
Before they return!
They return.
The enemy. So many enemies.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer, a minion of the mind flayers who abducted you.
Remove us
from this body,
from this case. Free us.
From this strange context, you notice nothing unusual about the brain. From the skull. But you notice an opportunity. You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient should it prove a threat. Your fingers twitch with the desire to rip its tender, moist meat to shreds.
Our freedom is ours, friend.
The creature pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
We must go to the helm.
At the helm, we are needed.
As though querying an unseen advisor.
Do you know?
cannot hear it. We will not survive here. We are needed
to navigate.
We are needed to leave this realm.
To the helm we go.
We are going to the helm.
Of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Skvar. You are no thrall. Vlakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. We carry mind flayer parasites. Unless we escape. Unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geth, mind flayers. Until we escape. That must be our priority. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. As for that thing, it will remain tame as long as it believes we are thralls. It may be of use in the fight to come.
You can take me on.
Victory awaits. Make way.
mind flayer machinery. Better watch what I touch. Unleash.
Damn it.
Can't read this script.
Inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod, commanding the person inside to change. Stares at you, weak and dazed. The console appears dormant. The console hums to life. But what is its purpose? Will it free the captive or transform her like that other unfortunate? Nothing in the appearance of the device betrays its purpose. It could do anything. It could even transform the occupant of the pod, like what happened before. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. The parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. Brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated.
Looks like there's plenty of fighting ahead. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment.
Finally. Let us make for the helm. We've wasted enough time already.
She's right. Lead on. Once inside, do as I say. Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment.
Kainyank. Deal with the Geich after we escape.
Connect the nerves.
Nerves?
We will connect them.
This thing's falling fast. Got to right it. I'm ready.
Breathing, despite everything. Let's get this over with. Time to strike. On the move. Nothing important is ever easy. Wonder if the gods are watching me. Victory awaits. Taking possession. Another fight. Let's go.
What path lies before me? It's clear. Hurry, before they strike. Victory awaits. Taking position. Give up. Moving. Come on. Can't stay idle. Death won't take me yet. What should I do? On I go.
You can eat.
Blood comes easy these days. Time to push my luck again. Time to strike.
Come a little closer.
Dull moment. Have to keep going. I am fury. I am death.
Your spine is mine.
I can't even catch my breath. Hope your soul is in good hands. Swift and lethal.
I'm intruders! There's important stay!
Responder. You made it in time. You half expected your memories to return once you were free of the Mind Flayership. But your past is still an aching void. If you don't find a way to remove the tadpole burrowed in your brain soon, your future will be as blank as your past. Your head whispers vengeance. You cannot wait to slice your way forth, seeking whatever wrought this tragedy upon you. Drink in the pungent corpse. Since you awoke on the ship, your mind has been cold and empty, but something stirs. With your hands close to this body, you know nothing of why, but you find a half smile flittering across your face. You see flashes of flesh, all lumped together in a mass grave. No single image sticks out. There is something unknown and unspeakable deep within your heart.
I'm alive. How is this possible? True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about. I remember the ship. I remember falling. The nothing. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby.
More of those wretched things.
Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
Tool will do the trick.
To go still.
All's well that ends. Not as bad as it could have.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it?
Just a dumb boar. You're relieved. Until you see the flash of a dagger.
I just need information. I saw you scuttling about on the ship. You're in league with them, aren't you? Those tentacle... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light. The fear.
What was that? What's going on? The worm. Of course. That explains things somewhat. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. A pleasure. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first. You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
As he joins your side, your mind dances with thoughts of a perfect, pretty corpse.
Watch your back.
All right. What now?
Just a brief respite.
There, a mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. This...
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Yes, you feel hate. And you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. The monster lies exhausted. Defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Monster. Death is too good for it.
Goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
What's going on with
That room looks unstable. Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
A hand? Anyone?
Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Nautiloid as well. I don't know what transpired exactly, but the ship broke into pieces and I suddenly found myself in freefall. As I was plummeting to certain death, I spied a glimmer quite near where I estimated my body to impact with less than savory propulsion. Recognizing this glimmer to be magical in nature, I reached out to it with a weaving of words and found myself on the other side, as it were. How about you? How did you survive the fall? Fair enough. But even so, I have the unfortunate suspicion your survival is still very much in jeopardy. Back on the ship, you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region. Were you not? No use sugarcoating it, is there? The insertee we speak of, this parasite? Are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent. Parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. An act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor. Charmed, I'm sure.
Ahead.
Seek and you shall find me.
Give up now.
go to hell. Ha! You're a good sport. Go to hell. An everyday expression. So trivial, it's almost meaningless. But we've seen hell. It's real. And it isn't trivial. Devils, dragons, mind flayers. They used to be abstracts. Pictures on a piece of paper. What a difference a day makes. Now we have tadpoles slithering through our heads like carnivorous foeti. That's not abstract. That's the spirit. Let's be up with the lark. Find a healer before the wee one gets hungry.
What were you two talking about? I see. I'd be careful with Gale. He's a wizard. All they care about is power. Let's hope we rapidly find a healer. You seem reliable. I think you know how important it is that we find someone who can cure us. Best if we focus on that. Good. We might even get lucky and find one right away. As I see it, we're overdue some good fortune. Rest well.
Do you mind? I'm...
As you writhe with sickly dreams, a deep dread floods you. Though you have a tadpole, you know your broken mind is not like the others who bear the worm. A few scraps of the past come back to you now and then. You can never quite tell where the knowledge comes from. Inexplicable, violent yearnings overwhelm all other thoughts. Who could you possibly be to be their vessel? You recall waking up, hearing the pounding war drum of blood. How much you treasured the sight of the first corpse you touched. Must be a way through this red fog. As you fall asleep, you are a shivering and shaking mess. Blood, 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 blood.
You look rabid, pained, sick. You're spasming and twitching. The poor thing. Well, so far, my tadpole and I have been nothing but best friends. Something else is happening to you, isn't it? You have bouts of swooning and swaying, and your jaw is grinding like you're poised to chew off your tongue. Do take care of yourself. What's to tell? I'm a magistrate back in the city. It's all rather tedious.
Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad, twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous. Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you... Oh, a guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white-hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
Get rid of them.
She's right. Let's go. We need to check out that blast. You didn't hear it. Shook our camp good, so we came for a look. Northwest. Look for Nettie. Whatever your wound, she can mend it.
And be careful. There are goblin traps everywhere.
Nymessa, come.
Enough gawking. Get me down. Never.
Observe and listen.
Enough dawdling. Get
You'll
me
hear
down.
Goblins before you see them.
As you say.
The tadpole hasn't yet scrambled all your senses. Auspicious. But the longer we wait, the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me.
Careful. She obviously sees your kindness as weakness. Don't let her take advantage.
It is many things. A hatchery, a training grounds, a shelter. Githyanki protocol is clear. When infected with a Geth tadpole, we must report to Augusto for purification.
You may as well suggest a wyvern bow to worms.
The cure I offer will suffice as thanks.
Make space, and my might is yours.
If I must. But do try to keep them safe. They're a little useless without me.
Well chosen. You have made an ally from Kresh-Kalir. Few know such fortune. Call me Lazel.
I'll trust your judgment, but I won't trust her. Not until I've gotten the measure of her.
You've a sharp tongue, elf. Would that your mind proved its equal.
Half elf. I suppose the finer details are lost on a creature like you.
Come. The Horned Ones mentioned a camp. One there, this Zoru, has seen Githyanki. A Kresh must be near. We will ask this Zoru where he has seen my kin. Flackets will be done. Let's move.
I hear shouting up ahead.
We should check it out, but be careful.
That might be worth a look. Wonder what's past this.
armed scribes. No sign of a struggle.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection.
The dead. This chapel must be ancient.
The inscription is in a language unknown.
Chatter
to
already.
Haste.
The only way out is through. Here we
go again.
A lot of effort to hide one sarcophagus.
Here lies the guardian of tombs. Through knowledge comes atonement.
So he has spoken, and so thou standest before me, right as always. What a curious way to awaken. Now, I have a question for thee. What is the worth of a single mortal's life? Curiosity. Nothing more. Wilt thou answer my question? Again, what is the worth of a single mortal life? In death, that is so. Very well. I am satisfied. We have met, and I know thy face. We will see each other again at the proper time and place. Farewell.
A strange coin. I wonder what it's worth.
Pushing on.
Be with you in a moment. Not a trick, my friend. Magic. Be that as it may. Seramorphosis. What does it make you think of? Spot on. Day one, fever and memory loss. Day two, hallucinations and graying skin. Day three, hair loss and blood leaking from all orifices. Need to go on? My point is this. Our orifices remain blissfully unblooded, our heads remain clear, and our blood temperature normal. Any expert will agree this is abnormal. I'll toast to that. The pragmatic in me, however, sees only the silence before the storm. Something to sleep on. We should get some rest.
Abominations grow inside us. Our bones should ache. Our mouths should bleed. Yet we thrive. It is madness. Keep your rest short. Time is not our ally.
I saw you getting a lecture from our magical friend. I have to say, I thought you'd look worse, but no. Not a tentacle to be seen. Indeed you could. We're all doing surprisingly well, given the circumstances. I'm not taking anything for granted, of course. First sign of change, and I'll have to stop that pretty little heart of yours. I am open to suggestions. Knives, poison, strangulation, whatever you'd prefer. Well, that's a little dramatic, don't you think? Come on, humor me. If you had to choose. A classic. One good thrust to the heart and you're gone. We need a good blade, of course. Don't want to waste time hacking and prodding with a dinner knife. Well, I'm getting ahead of myself. This is all a worst-case scenario, obviously. Oh, my dear. I'd like to see you try. Now, let's get some rest. The sooner we start tomorrow, the better our chances of keeping this hypothetical.
I couldn't help but overhear. Well, all right, I could have helped, but didn't. Anyway, I feel the same. Other than the occasional mental exchange, it's almost as if we're not infected. The voice on the ship told me I'd become a beautiful weapon. What do you think it meant? Agreed. We can't take the lack of symptoms for granted. All right. I've kept you from your blanket long enough. Rest well.
We meet again, as predicted. I shall be here in thy camp for whenever thou hast need of my services. There are many answers to that question. None are important.
Is a great divine energy indeed, but the source...
A mending of the threads between life and death. Should thou or any of thy compatriots perish, I will cleave soul to body once more. Because it is my calling, there is little else to explain.
Open the bloody gate!
Nobody gets in! Zevlor's orders!
That pack of goblins will be on us any second!
What's going on?
Goblins are on our tail! Open the gate, Zevlor, now!
You let goblins here? Where is the druid?
Please! There's no time!
The nine hells! Open the gates! The blade
and suffer its sting.
Ah!
my sickle and sword. Oh,
make way. One day I'll catch a break.
do I go from here? Shouldn't have made me your enemy.
That was the last of them. Inside! All of you! More may follow! Open the gate! Children here, you fool!
We was running for our lives.
You led them straight to us, and you let them take the druid too? Unbelievable!
And who the hell are you again?
Show some respect. This woman saved your pathetic life.
Well, I didn't ask for any goddamn help.
Please, you were begging me to open the gate. Anything to save yourself, you coward!
The human's eye twitches. He's about to blow.
You're right. There's too much at stake.
Worried about your precious eyes, the both of you.
Enough! Squabbling is pointless. The goblins have found us.
At least we agree on that.
More goblins could be on their way.
Time to pack. We need to leave.
Pardon.
This is about your precious Baldur's Gate.
I care about our lives.
Refugees, adventurers, no one in years, and suddenly we're overwhelmed. Well met, and thank you for beating back those goblins. Most brave of you. Is there anything you need? Act fast if you do. I forgot, you're a blow-in. A few days hence, this grove will be completely concealed by thorny vines. None will be able to enter or leave. A drastic measure. But more monsters seem to terrorize this region every day. We druids will be safe. As for those that took refuge here, well, may Sylvanas guard them as they continue their travels. As I said, it's a drastic measure, but the survival of the grove is paramount. There just aren't enough supplies to support everyone. Just some bits and bobs I no longer need. Sylvanas got...
Can we stop shouting? No?
Hells! We can't just leave. They're kin!
I'll not gamble our lives, our futures, on people who are as good as dead. We must leave for Baldur's Gate at once.
Can we all just take a moment, please?
What's the point in blazing spells if we don't bloody use them? We should stay. These people aren't fighters. We can help.
Or yell louder. That's fine too.
Just like I was saying, I don't want all these lives on my conscience. We need to stay.
Zerg. Fine. We'll stay. If we survive, it'll make for a good story, I suppose.
Thank you, Roland.
I'd die if I met Leroic and reeking of
Take
this
your
place.
Time.
I'll never get the
sea forever. Forever.
This is no fool. We're no warriors. Elbows high. Now pull back and swing.
Go on. Give me a best shot. Not bad. Again.
I can't do it. I'm not like you.
Umi, I don't need you to be like me. You just have to buy enough time to run. Come on. I believe in you. You can do this. You're on the right path, Umi. Go on now. Practice what you've learned. Well met. The Blade of Frontiers at your...
The man's smile bends downward, and his thoughts become yours. You are the Blade of Frontiers racing through the wastes of Avernus. Just ahead, a diabolical figure, red skin, single curled horn, blazes with flame, bloodied great axe held high.
Hell's great fires. You are on the ship. Better friends than the ones hitching a ride in our skulls, at least. I'm sure you know the stories. Doomed to shed our skin and become illithid. They say there's no coming back. But we haven't sprouted any tentacles. Not yet, anyway. Could just be good luck. I'm not so.
Your minds collide once more. Will chases the fiend, ignited with rancor. She is an infernal war devil. A threat to the living. Evil incarnate.
Shit! You saw her. Advocatus Diaboli.
Advocatus Diaboli, a devil's advocate, a champion in the blood war between diabolical forces and demons.
That ship sailed the Styx already. All I can hope for is to limit the damage. Her name is Karlak, an archdevil soldier I swore on my good eye to kill. I tracked her through the Hells to the Mindflayer ship, but the damned illithids infected me before I could end her. She's out there now, preying on the innocent. I don't kill her, she'll leave behind nothing but a trail of corpses. Just so you know, my first duty is Karlak.
I'm oath-bound to go after her. But I won't deny this infection is bothersome. I accept your invitation.
I'm up for the challenge. You've just got to make a little space.
Keeping your greatest weapon in reserve, eh? An excellent strategy.
Let's make this happen.
The famous Blade of Frontiers in the flesh. Clever, this hero act you've got going.
Hero, Blade. Name strangers gave me. My friends call me Will.
Excellent. If we ever become friends, I'll know what to call you.
Any questions, children?
A hero at heart.
By Mordai's eyes, another one. My friend's blood not enough. Come to rip me open too.
In Kresh Kalir, a formal greeting begins with a bow.
Is this monster with you?
You dare interrupt? Has the tadpole ravaged your senses? Chucky, fine.
On the road to Baldur's Gate, near the mountain pass. Saw us, for we saw it. Jammed its blade through Yul's belly. Straight to the other side. And I just ran.
The map. Show me.
No hard feelings.
The last time a subordinate questioned my judgment, I ate tongue stew that very night.
I warned you, didn't I? You ought to reconsider keeping her around before she causes real trouble.
Kinyak, your tantrum proves you no wiser than a hatchling. Teethling was clear. If there are Githyanki west of here, that must be our objective. Purification cannot wait. I am unfamiliar with the... well, I shall not say culture. Custom, perhaps. You will educate me on matters of this... Fey run. The Kresh holds the Zathisk. It will cleanse us of the parasite. By Covenant, I can say no more.
It's quite a sight. The stars, I mean. I could take or leave your chin. I can see the stars from Baldur's Gate, of course. But not with such clarity. It got me thinking. Reflecting on what tomorrow might bring. When we arrive at this Gith Kresh. Will we find out how to bring the worm under control? Will this little adventure of ours be over? Good. I don't want you to run off just yet. You're quite the ally, after all. Traversing Avernus, surviving the crash, surviving everything that's followed. I'm not easily impressed by people, but you're stronger than I gave you credit for. A delicious thought, but the right moment. I'm sorry. I need to clear my head. I'll see you later, I'm sure. Sleep tight.
A fine evening, don't you think?
The moonlight shines warmly on us. The breeze caresses our faces. Hideous. All of it. Would that I were doing battle up there, among the tears. Look above. Watch the moon cross the sky. The tears follow behind it. Rocky bodies tumbling through the sea of night. One of them is my crash. Kalir. Your curiosity is to be commended. Githyanki are hatched in creches all throughout realm space. Kalir is one of many. It's there I first saw a Kithrak mount a red dragon. Where I slit my cousin's throats at the Varsh's command. But enough of this. You are wasting your resting time. Come dawn, we resume our search for a creche.
A tingle runs through your head and down to your feet.
Ah, there it is. That shiver. Our little brainworms have made fast friends, it would seem. How do you feel? Surprising is just the word, isn't it? Before the Illithid's unscheduled surgery, I'd felled hundreds of beasts and a fair few fiends. The tadpoles weakened me, suppressed greater talents, but beyond that, I've showed no signs of turning. No nausea, no pain, not even a hot flash. Indeed. Perhaps the worm's vat was poisoned. Perhaps we're uncommonly fit. Or perhaps the tadpoles are merely on holiday. We could conjecture all night. I suppose the why doesn't matter so much as the what next. And that answer is plain as the horns on a war devil's head. We get these things out. Let's get some rest. Dawn comes sooner than we think.
The leader of the pack comes to chat. What's on your mind? You must be pleased to have a clear path forward. I can't wait to get this thing out of my head. Head to Baldur's Gate. Someone's waiting for me. Let a girl have some secrets. Was there anything else? The same. These parasites are proving suspiciously benign. But suppose I turn. What would you do?
Wise. Though, I hope you'd miss me after I'm gone. I think I would if the positions were reversed. But you're right. If we're to make it through all this, there can be no room for hesitation. You're doing well.
It's a beautiful night. I think I'll stay up to enjoy it while I still can. Rest well.
So, we're traveling with the famed Blade of Frontiers. I feel safer already.
Perhaps if you lost a follower or two, I prefer to travel in smaller groups. It's more in that case. I'd be happy to tag along.